students, welcome in chemistry classes. In our previous lectures, we have studied about the quantum mechanics, right? Okay, now we have to see one of the important topic of the physical chemistry, that is polymer chemistry. It is a very important topic and also it is a very short topic. We can cover this in the 3 to 4 videos. And this topic is very simple. The only formula based questions are asked from this topic, okay? So we have to just see the formulas and some basic details. We are not going in very details of this, okay? We have to see what is asked in the question paper, okay? Now see here. First thing is, what is the polymer? So see in a very short manner, what is a polymer? We all know about the monomers. It means whenever we are taking a simple unit as A, this is a very small unit, and when it is repeated again and again, okay? So we are getting a long chain in this way, right? A long chain we are getting in this way, okay? This will have a very large molecular weight. Such type of compounds are known as polymers. So this long chain of the molecule with a large molecular weight is known as the polymer. For example, consider this molecule. This is ethylene molecule, okay? And when these ethylene molecules are joined together linearly in this manner, we are getting a long chain of these molecules in this way, right? In this way, we will get a long chain that will have a very large molecular weight. So this will be called now polyethylene, okay? Polyethylene or polyethylene. That is a polymer of ethylene, right? So in this way, we should know about the polymers. This is the basic of the polymers. Now we are considering the molecular weight, average molecular weight of the polymers. Okay, now we have to study a very important topic, that is average molar masses of the polymers or average molecular weights of the polymers. So why we take the average molecular masses of the polymers? Why we cannot take the accurate masses? Actually, what happens when the polymerization reaction happens? We are getting the different polymer chains of the different length. It means in some of the polymer chains, we have the monomer units like N. In some, it may be N plus 1 or N plus 2, etc. It means we are getting the polymer chains of different molecular weights. And we know that these molecular weights are determined by different methods. These are the methods by which these molecular weights are determined. So the weight that we are finding is an average of the accurate weight. So we are taking here the average molecular weights. Okay, so now see here, there are 4 different types of the average molecular weights of the polymers, and these are actually due to the different methods that we are using here. Okay, by different methods we are finding the different molecular weights. Number one is the number average molar mass, that we denote by this MN. Okay, and whenever we are using the osmometry method for finding out the molecular weight, then the weight that we are finding out is the number average molar mass. Okay, similarly another one is the weight average molar mass, and it is denoted by MW, and this is obtained by the light scattering method. Okay, third one is the Z average molar mass, that is denoted by MZ, and it is obtained by sedimentation method, right? And fourth one is the viscosity average molar mass, that is denoted by MV, and it is obtained by viscosity method. I have shown you the methods also. Why? Because one time the question has been asked that which molar mass is obtained from which method, such type of question in the MCQ of 2 mark. Okay, so if you know, then you can do the such type of questions easily. Okay, okay, now see the first type, that is number average molar mass or MN. So we should know the formulas of these all, okay? Because formula based questions are asked in the question paper, I will also solve the questions. Firstly, see what are their formulas, okay? So we will do it very quickly. See here, the formula for this is summation of Ni, Mi upon summation of Ni. Here Ni is what? Ni is the number of the molecules having a particular molar mass, and Mi is that particular molar mass. Suppose we have different polymer chains of N1, N2, N3 numbers. These are the numbers. It means N1 number of the chains of the molecular weight M1, N2 number of the chains having the molecular weight M2, N3 number of chains having the molecular weight M3, in this way. And now we have to find out the number average molar mass. Then it is given by the summation of this all. It means N1 M1 plus N2 M2 plus N3 M3 divided by the number of the chains. It means N1 plus N2 plus N3 in this way. So we have to use this formula, right? Second is the weight average molar mass. That is denoted by MW, and this is the bar over here because we have taken here the average molar mass, right? So the formula for it is, this is a summation of Ni Mi square upon summation of Ni Mi, or we can also write it in this manner because I have seen the question based on this formula, so you should learn this also. This can also be written in this manner, right? So what here we have to do, just we have to sum up in this manner. Suppose we have the number of the chains in this way, N1, N2, N3 similarly, and their molecular weights are M1, M2, etc. So we have to write down here N1, M1 square plus N2, M2 square plus N3, M3 square in this way, and then we have to divide by N1, M1 plus N2, M2 plus N3, M3 in this manner, right? Third type is the jet average molar mass. That is not so much important because I have not seen the questions based on this, but I am showing you the formula because it may be that they will ask about this particular formula, so you should learn the formula. What is here the formula? NZ is the summation of Ni Mi cube divided by summation of Ni Mi square, okay, in this way, and we can also write it in this manner, M cube average divided by average of M square in this way, right? So similar thing we have to do as we have done previously, right? In this way we can find out the Z average molar mass. Okay, the last type and very important type is the viscosity average molar mass, that we denote by MV bar, okay? And this is given by, this is the one formula, summation of Ni Mi 1 plus A divided by summation of Ni Mi power 1 upon A. Okay, this is one formula, but more important formula that you should know is this formula, that is this is equal to K MV bar to the power A. This is a very important formula, and this equation is known as the Mark-Cohn equation. Actually, this equation is known as Mark-Cohn-Huving-Sakurada equation. But in the question papers, if you have seen, you will find out there that we have given in from this Mark-Cohn equation, and you have seen that question papers, 2 mark questions, 2 to 3 times have been asked based on this particular equation, that we know this equation by which name. So the name of this equation is Mark-Cohn equation. Here this bar, eta bar, this is known as the intrinsic viscosity. Okay, and this is the viscosity average molar mass, right? And these K and A are the constant. Okay, and there is a question on which factors these two constants depends, and we know that these two constants depends upon the solvents and the macromolecule nature. Okay, right, these two will depend upon the nature of the solvent and the nature or the geometry of the macromolecule. Okay, this A value is almost from 0.5 to 1, okay, and this depends upon the geometry of the macromolecule. Okay, so this is all about this equation. Now there is one more equation similar to this equation, that is this one. दिस इंट्रिंसिक विस्कोसिटी इज इक्वल टू लिमिट सी टेंस टू जीरो ईटा माइनस ईटा नॉट डिवाइडेड बाय सी ईटा नॉट. ओके एंड दिस विल बी इक्वल टू लिमिट सी टेंस टू जीरो ईटा अपॉन ईटा नॉट माइनस वन डिवाइडेड बाय सी. हियर दिस ईटा नॉट, दिस ईटा नॉट इज द विस्कोसिटी ऑफ द प्योर सॉल्वेंट. And this eta, this is the viscosity of the solution. And about C, we all know this is the concentration term. So what we can consider from this equation, we can consider that when the concentration is extrapolated to zero, when it tends to zero, then this intrinsic viscosity is equal to eta upon eta naught minus 1 divided by C. Okay, and there is a question particularly based on this formula that has been asked in the CSIR NET exam. So I have given you this particular equation. I am solving that question and then I will solve some more questions. Okay, so see here. Okay, so firstly see this question on the viscosity. Okay, then we will see some more questions on the weight average and the number average, molecular masses and the polydispersity index. Okay, so see this question from June 2013. The question is using the standard equation for intrinsic viscosity. It is equal to KmV to the power A. For a solution of polymer and information from the graph, identify viscosity average molar mass. So we have to find out this and we have given the values of the constants, right? We have given this graph. Now we can see here at this x-axis we have plotted here concentration term. Okay, and at the y-axis we have plotted this one eta minus eta naught upon eta naught divided by C. And we have already seen this formula that intrinsic viscosity is equal to limit C tends to 0 and this eta minus eta naught divided by eta naught and divided by C, right? This thing we have given in the graph, we can see its value at the zero concentration, and we have seen that at zero concentration this is the value of it. It means 0.050, this is the value at C is equal to 0. So this will be equal to our intrinsic viscosity. Okay, so now we have to find out the viscosity average molar mass, and what is our formula? Eta is equal to K mv to the power A. Now we have to put here just the values. So 0.050 is equal to K's value is 5 into 10 to power minus 5. Okay, you should also write here the limit, these units. Okay, I am not writing here the units, but you should write here. Okay, and this value is 0.5. okay, so we can write this is equal to half. So we can write here it to the power half will be equal to 0.50 divided by this is 0.050, okay, divided by 5 into 10 to power minus 5, right? So this value will come 10 to power 3, right? Now this is mv to the power half. If we take its square, then it will be equal to mv. So we can take its square. So just take its square. So we have to take here a square also. In this way, right? So what we are getting, this mv is equal to 10 to power 6, and what is its value in grams per mole. Okay, so you can match your option, this will be the answer, right? Okay, another important thing here is the polydispersity index, that is denoted by PDI. Okay, actually it is nothing, it is the ratio of this weight average molar mass and the number average molar mass. Okay, simply we have to divide this weight average molar mass by the number average molar mass so that we can find out PDI. Okay, polydispersity index. Suppose we have given a monodisperse sample. Monodisperse means this PDI is equal to 1. Okay, so we can say that MW upon MN will be equal to 1 here. So we can say that this weight average molar mass in the case of the monodisperse sample will be equal to number average molar mass. Okay, similarly if we have given dye dispersed, then this will be equal to 2. Okay, this is only the thing about this polydispersity index. Now see, another important thing is the probability density curve, and that is also very simple thing, but there is a question asked on it, so I am giving you about this information. Okay, poly probability density curve for the molar masses. Okay, now how to make it? See here, this shows just the distribution of the molar mass in a typical polymer sample. Okay, so here we have to show the probability, and at this axis we have to show the molar masses, and we are finding a graph in this way. Okay, this is showing the distribution of the molar masses, right? So actually what happens here, we are getting at this point, we are getting MN. Okay, this is the thing to remember. At this point we are getting viscosity average molar mass, right? At this point we are getting MW molar mass. Okay, and at this point we are getting the Z average molar mass, right? This is the thing about this, that you have to remember. Okay, nothing else, because there is a question in December 2016 question paper. If you have seen the question paper, we have given such type of graph, and we have given numbering A, B, C, and we have to find out which one is which. So we can easily say that this one is the MN, second is the MV, and third one is the MW. Okay, okay, now see the another question from December 2018. Here in the question, I have not written here the question. See here, we have given in the question that the number of molecules is 50. 50 molecules will have the molar mass 5000. Okay, these are the molar mass 5000, and 75 molecules will have the molar mass 6000. Okay, and now we have to find out the number average molar mass. So this question is very simple, and this has been asked in the 4 marks. So you can do such type of questions very easily if you know a little bit about the polymer chemistry, right? So do here, what we have to do here, N1 M1 plus N2 M2 divided by N1 plus N2. Okay, so just put here the values. This is 50 into 5000 plus 75 into 6000 divided by 50 plus 75, and when you are calculating this, this will be equal to 5600 grams per mole. Okay, this will be the answer of this question, right? Now similar type of question has been asked in the June 2017. Okay, now see here, what is the question? We have given a poly dispersed sample, and 10 molecules have the molar mass 20,000. This is in gram per mole. Okay, you can see the question paper. And 15 molecules have the molar mass, that is 10,000 grams per mole. Okay, and again we have to find out the number average molar mass. So we know the formula. Now just put the values here. So 10 into 20,000 plus 15 into 10,000 divided by 10 plus 15. Okay, now you can calculate this one. So we will get 35,000 divided by 25. So it will be equal to 14,000. Okay, this will be our answer, 14,000 gram per mole. Okay, this will be our answer. Okay, now see the next question from December 2015 question paper. Here we have to find out an expression for the product of number average molar mass and the weight average molar mass. Okay, we have given 4 different options. I have not written here. You can see in the question paper. So we know for the number average molar mass, what is the formula? Summation of Ni, Mi divided by summation of Ni. And for the weight average molar mass, what is the formula? Summation of एन आई एम आई स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाई समेशन ऑफ एन आई एम आई राइट. नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट इट्स प्रोडक्ट एंड इट्स प्रोडक्ट विल बी इट्स मल्टीप्लिकेशन. सो डू हियर इट्स मल्टीप्लिकेशन डिवाइडेड बाई समेशन ऑफ एन आई टाइम्स समेशन ऑफ एन आई एम आई स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाई समेशन ऑफ एन आई एम आई. ओके दीज टर्म्स आर सेम सो इट विल कैंसिल आउट राइट. नाउ वाट वी आर फाइंडिंग आउट हियर समेशन ऑफ एन आई एम आई स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाई समेशन ऑफ एन आई. ओके नाउ समेशन ऑफ एन आई इट मीन्स वेरियस नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स. सपोज वन चेन इज एन वन मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड अदर चेन इज एन टू मॉलिक्यूल्स थर्ड चेन इज एन थ्री मॉलिक्यूल्स इन दिस वे. सो द टोटल नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स विल बी इक्वल टू एन द टोटल नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स इन ए पॉलीमर सैंपल. ओके सो वी कैन रिप्लेस दिस समेशन ऑफ एन आई बाई एन. सो वी हैव टू राइट हियर समेशन ऑफ एन आई एम आई स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाई एन. ओके एंड इन द क्वेश्चन पेपर वी हैव गिवेन दिस इन द माइनस ऑर्डर. ओके माइनस पावर सो वी कैन टेक इट अपवर्ड. ओके वी कैन टेक इट इन द न्यूमरेटर. सो वाट वी आर फाइंडिंग हियर दिस विल बी एन टू पावर माइनस वन समेशन ऑफ एन आई एम आई स्क्वायर. सो दिस विल बी अवर आंसर. ओके नाउ सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिसंबर 2014 क्वेश्चन पेपर. वी हैव गिवेन अ सैंपल एक्सपेरिमेंट रिवील्ड दैट पीवीसी फॉर्म्ड इन द मीडियम हैज दिस एवरेज नंबर एवरेज मॉलिकुलर वेट इक्वल टू 13 एंड एमडब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू 16. ओके एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वेरियंस ऑफ एमएन. दिस वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. ओके सो फॉर दिस व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर वेरियंस. सी हियर दिस विल बी इक्वल टू एम एन स्क्वेयर एम डब्ल्यू अपॉन एम एन माइनस वन. ओके दिस इज द फॉर्मूला. यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट डाउन दिस फॉर्मूला राइट. सो जस्ट पुट हियर द वैल्यूज 13 स्क्वेयर एंड हियर 16 अपॉन 13 माइनस वन इन दिस वे. ओके सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू 13 स्क्वेयर विल बी 169 इनटू हियर व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग दिस विल बी 16 अपॉन 13 एंड दिस विल बी 16 अपॉन 16. सो वी आर गेटिंग हियर 3 बाई 13. ओके सो नाउ वी आर गेटिंग हियर 39. सो द वेरियंस ऑफ नंबर एवरेज मोलर मास विल बी इक्वल टू 39. ओके सो इन दिस वे यू हैव टू डू ऑल द क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन द नंबर एवरेज मॉलिकुलर वेट वेट एवरेज मॉलिकुलर वेट एंड द विस्कोसिटी एवरेज मोलर मास. ओके सच टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आर आस्क्ड फ्रीक्वेंटली. सो इन द मीट यू इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी हैव टू डू सम मोर थिंग्स लाइक कंटूर लेंथ एंड एवरेज एंड टू एंड डिस्टेंस इटीसी दैट वी विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. थैंक यू.